I'm a Christian, a patriotic American, and a free market, shrink the government conservative who happens to be gay. When it comes to my political beliefs, my orientation is only one part of the story. It's not the totality of who I am. What I mean by that is my values define me.
That video going viral with more than 500,000 views on social media yesterday, less than 24 hours after it was posted. Joining me now with more is political editor for townhall.com and Fox News contributor and our friend Guy Benson. Hey, Guy, great to see you.
Hey, good morning.
Good morning. Okay, so why did you come out with this video? This video was for Prager University, and you spoke out about your sexual orientation, but you put that as a footnote, and that's how you decided to come out that you were gay. But what were the issues that are most important to you? You say this doesn't define me, right?
Right. So basically, Prager University is this incredible platform. Since I just checked my phone a few moments ago, we're up to almost 750,000 views on this video in less than 24 hours. And they talk about at Prager University a lot of different issues, and they have people talking about issues that matter to them. And this is an issue that they said, hey, let's talk about identity politics. And sometimes as a gay conservative, Ainsley, I feel almost like I'm being asked by people to justify my existence. Mm-hmm. How can you be both of these things? And the answer is very easily, because just because I happen to be gay doesn't mean that I have to prioritize gay rights issues as my number one issue all the time. I don't. I care about shrinking the size of government, keeping America safe and strong. I'm pro-life. There's a lot of things that inform my worldview and my values, and who I am sexually is just one element of that. And I think that's totally fine. And I wanted to do the video not to go around telling people, oh my gosh, I'm gay, you should care about my sexual orientation. I think it should be irrelevant. I just see so many people who are not just gay, but who are black and conservative, who are Hispanic and conservative, women who get so much heat because they don't shoehorn their beliefs into this little tiny box that the identity politics lefts insist that they ought to inhabit. I think that's wrong, and I wanted to speak out on that.
Guy, you know, things are changing. You're right. People expect all women to march in the marches and put every woman in this one box. They think if you're gay, you need to vote for the Democrat. If you're a white man, you're going to vote for the Republican. If you're white, you're going to be a Republican. If you're black, you're going to be a Democrat. But you're saying this is a new era. You show a graph that was interesting to me in that video. You said between 14% and 27% of LGBT voters voted Republican in the past four elections.
Yeah. And so, I mean, it's already a minority of a minority. I understand that. But still, if you do the math, that's millions of people. So I hear all the time from fellow right-leaning members of the LGBT community, and they feel like they are so alone. And part of my message is, you're not. I know that sometimes the gay left is very loud and they can be bullies from time to time, but there are millions of us out there, and it's up to each of us to decide what our political priorities are and who we are as people. And it's just a permission slip. It's okay. Let's think critically and make our own decisions. And if we disagree, that's fine too.
All right. Thank you so much, Guy, for being on with us.
Thanks, Ainsley.
You're welcome.